The more I felt the push in my
all
spirit.
Right, yes,
yes, you are.
Glory.
So if you have your Bibles with no delay, I would that you turn with me to St. Matthew's.
Yes.
One of the synoptic gospels.
Thank you, Jesus.
Chapter 26, beginning at the 14th verse.
Yes.
Again, we thank God for the invitation to come. Yes. I count it not a privilege, but an honor to stand behind this record dress. It could have been anybody else, but we thank God that it is I.
Yes.
Amen. If you have it, say read it.
Read it.
If you don't have it, I'm going to read it anyhow. Matthew 26, verse 14, and it reads, "Then one of the 12 called Judas Iscariot,
yes,
went unto the chief priests and said unto them, What will ye give me? And I will deliver him unto you.
Mm-hmm.
And they conferred with him for 30 pieces of silver.
Mm-hmm.
And from this time he sought opportunity to betray him."
Mm-hmm.
Turn with me now to the 47th verse. "And when he yet spoke, lo, Judas, one of the 12, came with him a great multitude, with swords and shovels from the chief priests and elders of the people.
Mm-hmm.
Now he that betrayed him gave them a sign, saying, Whomsoever I shall kiss, that shall he say, Hold him fast.
Mm-hmm.
And from with he came to Jesus and said, Hail, Master, and kissed him.
Mm-hmm.
And Jesus said unto him, Friend." And Jesus said unto him, Friend, wherefore art thou come?
Mm-hmm.
Then came they and laid hands on Jesus and took him.
Mm-hmm.
If I were to speak on tonight, I want to speak from the topic, unrecognized friend.
Oh God.
Yes.
Unrecognized friend. Let us pray, Father. Can we stand again?
Yes, Lord.
Need you to be God more than ever. I ask now that you decrease this flesh known as Brian.
Yes,
that you'll fend forth your glorious treasures to fill this earthly vessels again.
Yes.
Speak now, O God, words of wisdom to these your people.
Yes, God.
Let them know, O God, that you are God, and besides you there is no other.
Yes, Lord.
So therefore, this is your servant's prayer.
Yes,
in Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. You may have your seats in the presence of the Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Unrecognized friend. Brothers, sisters, saints, and friends, I need you to understand in this world today, we have a lot of people that we call friends.
Mm-hmm.
We have a lot of people that we call our associates, or must I say our best friend.
Mm-hmm.
One that we trust and we give all our secrets to.
Mm-hmm.
One that we think that know us even better than ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
Then we have what we call friends of friends. One we know through another person. Then we even have family that get on our nerves so bad that we even call them a friend in public rather than family.
Mm-hmm.
But my brothers, sisters, saints, and friends, I need you to understand also that it's also known as a false friend.
Mm-hmm.
This person comes along not only to abuse you,
mm-hmm,
but to manipulate you.
Mm-hmm.
They come to suck the very life out of you.
Mm-hmm.
My grandma always told me, baby, be careful for leeches.
Mm-hmm.
For they come only to get the blood out of you.
Whoa.
I need you to understand, people of God, there's a lot of people that come in your life only to suck the life out of you.
Yes.
But they come only to see what they can get out of you to make themselves look better.
Yes. Yes.
They come to see and lose you and get all your secrets.
Yes.
And then spread your name across the city.
Yes.
I need you to understand, my grandma also said, baby, there's some people that don't have the best intent at heart for you.
Yes, yes.
But David said, I love it the way he put this, create in me a clean heart,
yes,
and renew a right spirit within me.
Oh, yes.
Restore the bone that ye have used for your glory.
Yes,
I cannot stand people that do wrong and don't feel anything.
Yes.
Can I preach it here for a little while?
Yes,
let me let you understand that worldliness is not a good friend to have.
That's right.
It is a false friend. I hear the Lord say in James 4 and 4, he said, friendship with the world is empathy with God.
Yes, yes.
You have to be careful about allowing people who have worldliness in their mindset to be close to you.
Yes.
Because after a while, their thinking will rub off on you.
Yeah.
Because you cannot even watch everything on television.
That's right.
Some of us have forgotten that television has an off switch.
Right. Yes.
Yes, you use the television as a babysitter.
Uh-huh.
You use the television as a nightlight.
Yes.
You use the television when you go to sleep.
Mm.
When you wake up.
Uh-huh.
When you're doing what you do throughout the day, the television is constantly streaming garbage into your spirit.
Yes.
You got to be careful about worldliness, because in the long run it will mess you up.
Yes.
I wish I had the time, but there's another false friend that is known as ease.
Yeah.
I hear Amos say in Amos 6:1, woe to them that are at ease in Zion.
Yes.
I did not fully understand this, Bishop,
uh-huh.
because I was raised in church, and sometimes church would just wear you out.
Yes.
Jesus even said, the zeal of thine house has eaten me up.
Yes.
And he said to his disciples, come away with me,
yes.
that we may rest for a while. But there is a difference between rest and ease. Ease is when you forget that you have obligations and duties.
Yes.
Ease is when you forget that you have the mentality that somebody else can do this.
Uh-huh.
I know that there are ushers, but this is a nice church, so somebody else can do it.
Mm-hmm.
We can find somebody else to pass our programs.
Uh-huh.
I know that they need somebody to teach church school,
mm-hmm.
but there's plenty of folk around here. I'm going to take my ease.
Uh-huh.
Let me tell you, there is a danger at being at ease.
Let me
tell you, there is a danger at being at ease.
Yes.
I find in Psalms 123:4 where it says, our soul is exceedingly filled with the scorning of those that are at ease.
Yes.
And with the contempt of pride. And so there is that ease will lead us to scorning.
Yes.
Do you know when the biggest problem in the church are the folks who do nothing at all?
Uh-huh.
The biggest problem, Pastor, is those that don't want to do nothing but always criticize those that do something.
Yes, sir.
Uh-huh. The main ones that don't want to sing on the choir but has a problem with the music that's played in the church.
Lord.
Is the main ones that has the problem with the one that sing and pray all the time, the one that pay the tithe, the one that has something to say, the one that attends the meeting. Them are the main ones.
Yes, sir.
That somebody has something to say about.
Yes, sir.
But there anybody in here that can say with me, for God I live.
Oh, yes.
And for God I die. Woe unto them that are at ease, because ease is not your friend.
Yeah.
But there is another false friend I want to expose for a minute. It is unmerited popularity.
Mm-hmm.
I hear the Lord Jesus say, woe unto you whom all men speak well of you.
Mm-hmm.
You got to be careful about folk who will jive you.
Yes, sir. Preacher.
I heard a long time ago a minister that listened to some of what everybody has to say. I learned not to believe my own press report.
Yes.
We have some folk that would tell you, I love you.
Yes.
I love you.
Yes.
I love you.
Yes.
And watch when someone say, I'll never leave you.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And say that I'll be there through the thick and the thin.
Oh, yes.
But as soon as it gets thick, they begin to thin.
Right on out. Yes, sir.
There comes some times where you call your enemies your friend.
Yeah.
But there comes another time where danger will you call a friend an enemy.
Yeah.
They are only called unrecognized friend.
Yeah.
That is what I love about our text today, is that Jesus recognized Judas as being a friend.
Yeah.
I would not have thought Judas as being a friend. I am not a country music fan.
Mm-hmm.
But there's some of the lyrics of a song that I love.
Mm-hmm.
Kenny Rogers said, you got to know when to fold them.
Preach, Kenny.
You got to know when to fold them. You got to know when to walk away.
Yes.
And you need to know when to run. Another songwriter talked about unrecognized love. He said, I brought the shoes that just ran out on me. My all-time favorite is that Papa Loves Mama. Mm-hmm. Mama loves men.
Yeah.
That's why Mama's in the grave and Papa's in the pen. See, French will do you in.
Preach, man.
And it's hard to forgive somebody that hate and betray you.
Yes, sir.
But I look at Jesus.
Hallelujah.
He washed the feet that walked out on him.
Yeah.
I looked at Jesus. He knew what Judas was all about.
Yes, sir.
He knew that Judas had sold him out.
Yes,
he knew that Judas had betrayed him, but Jesus called him a friend. I feel like preaching now. What kind of love is this? What kind of love is this that sees me at my worst? That can see me betray God, but still call me a friend?
Yes,
that he can see me at the breaking of my facing?